You know that users hate waiting for websites to load. They really do. Even a few seconds of a website loading can be a reason enough for your users' churn. This is why you want your website speed to be as fast as possible. So, how long does it take your website to load? Let us know in the comments down below. Hi, I'm Anna, the header girl at 10web, a managed WordPress hosting platform powered by Google Cloud. In this video, I'm going to show you the importance of website speed, and I'll show you the test results that we have conducted based on four of the most popular WordPress hosting platforms out there. I'll show you the results and we can interpret them together. If you're new to our channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to receive notifications about our latest posts. So let's talk about the importance of website speed. Website speed has a direct impact on the Google rankings, any search engine rankings that your website may have. So whenever you have a slow website, it is going to affect the user experience, which will primarily impact your conversions and bounce rate as well. Speed is the first touch with your brand and product or service. So the faster your website is, the more reliable and professional it will look like. And obviously, whenever people go into your website, speed is going to be one of the first things that they interact with. So it's a really good first impression, which you want to be there for sure. Slow websites affect your conversion rates, meaning that you are going to lose a lot of customers and revenue as a result. So that is why you want to make sure that your website speed is very fast, especially the speed of your mobile, since most of the searches nowadays are being conducted through mobile. So you do want to pay a huge attention to that one as well. Now, another thing that you should know is that whenever people, spend a lot of money using ads, Google ads or social media ads, a lot of traffic is going to come to your website. And in these cases as well, you do not want them to spend money on bringing people and then not letting them convert because of the speed of your website. So you just want to bring everything under control through the speed of your website. Taking all these aspects into consideration, you do need to choose a WordPress hosting platform that is as fast as possible. But which WordPress hosting platform is the fastest? Let us find out together. We have conducted a case study and created four websites using the same template and hosted it with 10web, HostGator, GoDaddy, and Bluehost. And then after that, we measured their page speeds using the Google Page Speed Insights tool. And then after that, we had the information about how fast each website is with the each hosting provider and already had a conclusion as to which WordPress hosting provider gives the best results fast speed-wise. The Google Page Speed Insights tool takes your website, measures its speed, and grades it from 0 to 100. Anything between 0 to 49 is considered to be a very slow website and a very bad result. Anything between 50 to 89 is an okay result, and anything between 90 to 100 is considered to be a really fast website. We also measured the speed index, which basically shows how fast the content of your website is becoming visible whenever a person clicks on the URL of your website. So anything below 3 seconds is considered to be a good score, but you want it to be as low as possible and as closer to zero so that you're sure that your website's content becomes visible very fast, because people usually do not like to wait for your content to load and they just leave as soon as they feel like it's going to take a while.
So before showing you the test results that we had with all of the hosting providers that I just mentioned earlier in the video, I would like to walk you through these hosting providers, tell you a bit about them, and then maybe show you their pricings so that you have other things to compare besides how fast all of these WordPress hosting providers are. So we will start with 10web, which is basically a managed WordPress hosting platform, which is powered by Google Cloud, and it guarantees that your website, if it's built with one of the templates of 10web itself, will get a Google PageSpeed score of over 95. And of course, if any other website that is migrated from another host comes to 10web, it is going to become super fast. And they're all going to get a uptime of 99.99%, which is amazing. Now, during these speed test results, the website hosted on TenWeb got a mobile page speed score of 93, and the desktop score was 100, which is the absolute maximum that you can possibly get in terms of Google page speed score. And the speed index was 0.7 seconds, which is extremely fast, and that's just amazing. Now, about the speed solution of TenWeb, a few things that I can mention is that when you create a new website on TenWeb or migrate your existing website from elsewhere, it automatically gets a desired 95 plus score, as I already mentioned. The solution is connected with three bundles of components, and the first one would be that TenWeb uses the last generation of servers, SSD storage, and the highly reliable Google Cloud Platform's premium tier network for the hosting implementation. Second, there is a developed state-of-the-art hosting infrastructure using containerization, caching, and Elastic resource management. And the third would be that TenWeb automatically optimizes your website's images, it minimizes the JavaScript and CSS files, and it lazy loads the resources and etc. Now, pricing wise, a single website hosted at TenWeb will have to pay $10 a month. And in case you host six or more websites at TenWeb, you will have to pay $6 per website per month, which is basically a very competitive price because managed WordPress hostings on average usually offer at least twice as much prices. So this is basically a price of a shared hosting that you would usually pay. And you get a lot of features and components with the plan. You can check out everything at tenweb.io. Now, let me move on to the next hosting provider that we will be examining, which is HostGator. So HostGator is the next one on our list, and it is one of the top web hosting providers today. HostGator is also one of the top trusted hosting companies and currently powers millions of domains worldwide. HostGator has posted 99.98% uptime over the past few years, which is amazing. Now let me tell you a bit about the test results that we got with HostGator. I should mention that their mobile score was 64 and the desktop one was 79. Both are very average indicators, and it's not considered to be fast at all. And the speed index was 3.3 seconds, which is also pretty slow, surprisingly. So as you see, the results are extremely slow if you compare them to the one of TenWeb's. Now, let's check out their pricing. As you see here, it says that the pricing starts at $595 per month, but just to be fair about the comparison, you are obviously going to want to get an SSL certificate in order to have more secure connections, and HostGator does offer you that. So if we select an SSL certificate from right over here and go down here to see what the total amount would be on a yearly basis, it says that it's going to be $270 per year. And if we compare this to TenWeb's $120 per year in case of one website hosted, and it already also included a lot more features and components, and it's not just a regular shared hosting, it is a managed WordPress hosting. Obviously, TenWeb is winning pricing-wise, also speed-wise, like I said a minute ago about the results of the experiment that we had. But we are going to go deeper into that later on, so let's not focus on this one right now, and let's move on to the next hosting platform that we've chosen, which is GoDaddy. So speaking about GoDaddy, I do need to mention that they're the biggest market share owners in the hosting industry. It offers a variety of hosting solutions. It has 11 benefits, including things like 99.99% uptime guarantee, money back guarantee, mail for businesses, which is free for the first year, which is still good, and also access to thousands of free themes and plugins, which is also great. However, let's talk about the speed results that we got with GoDaddy for a moment. I do need to mention that their mobile speed score was 66 and the desktop one was a 79. And also their speed index was 3.1 seconds. So basically everything is a lot below average. A 66 mobile score is way below average. 79 is still below average. And then 3.1 seconds is also very slow. As I mentioned earlier in my video, anything that's over 3 seconds is very bad. So in case of speed indexes, you want your score to be as close to zero as possible, and 3.1 is pretty slow. Now let's go to and check out their pricing and see if at least pricing wise they're doing good. So the basic plan of theirs is $6.99 per month. However, this is a discounted price, and the regular one would be $9.99 per month. However, let's just add this to cart, and even with a discounted price, let's see how much the subtotal would be. So I am going to pick the 12-month one because we have been comparing the yearly prices of the previous hosting platforms, and then let's go down here and go ahead and check the website security, which is actually going to add $5.59 per month additional money for the hosting, and then we do want an SSL certificate added as well, and that's going to add $6.67 a month for the SSL. Both of these are included in TownWeb, and they're included for absolutely free. And the great thing about TownWeb is that it also has a lot more features and components there. So by adding these as well, it's going to have a subtotal of $242 compared to $120 that TownWeb had to offer. And I think it's a bit less than what we had with HostGator. Let me quickly check that. And yes, with HostGator, we did have $270, but with GoDaddy, it is a $242, both of which are shared hostings, do not have many features and components that TownWeb has, and they're basically, they both had very bad, below average scores speed-wise. So basically, by far, TownWeb is winning, let's say. We do have one more hosting provider to compare, and then we'll go ahead and conduct a more visualized comparison between all these hosting providers so that you have a lot better understanding about their performances. So the next one that we would examine is Bluehost. So this was supposed to be the website of Bluehost, but today, the whole day, I have been having trouble accessing their website. As you see, it says that it's waiting for bluehost.com, meaning that they're actually, the website is down, and it just won't load. Let me just quickly try and give it another shot for it. As you see, it is going to load endlessly, and it won't eventually end up showing the content at all, which is very unfortunate because I did want to have a fair comparison of their pricing as well. But I guess we will have to skip that for now, since I'm really having trouble accessing their website. So just a quick information about Bluehost. Bluehost is known to be one of the leading web hosting solutions in the market. They offer WordPress hosting, VPS hosting, dedicated hosting, and WooCommerce hosting. And also they claim to have a 99.99% uptime. They're also known to be one of the cheapest WordPress hosting providers in the market. So we will go deeper into their pricing, but before that, let me tell you about the speed results that they had. So the mobile page speed score of theirs would be 62, and the desktop speed score was 74. Both are below average. So if you're looking for a fast WordPress hosting provider, obviously this isn't the best choice of yours. Also, a very surprising result was their speed index indicator, which was 6.7 seconds, meaning that whenever users come to this website, they would have to wait for 6.7 seconds for the content to actually show up, which is very, very slow. As I already mentioned, 3 was the tops that you could have, but I don't know, 6 seconds is very, very slow, and you have the potential risk to lose many, many visitors to your website. Now, as they have been claiming, actually not they, but they are famous for being one of the cheapest WordPress hosting providers. Let's check out their prices of the basic plan. So right now they're having discounts, and it's $3.95 a month for a single website hosted, but normally it would be $7.99. Let's just select this and see what the subtotal would be. So we're going to skip this step since we do not have a domain. Okay, so over here, you will have to fill in your information. Here, we're going to pick the 12-month price. And we're going to go down here and check this SEO tools as well, because this is something that TenWeb offers. And if you want to have equal grounds, then we're just going to check this as well. And yeah, basically that's all they offer. And the subtotal would become $167, which is still more than TenWeb. Of course, if we compare this to the rest of the shared hostings, which was Bluehost and HostGator, it is a lot less. But if we compare this to TenWeb, which is a managed WordPress hosting instead of a shared hosting, and it has a lot more features, a lot more components, with TenWeb, you would get you would have to pay $120 a year for a single website, and here you're going to have to pay $167. So although they're known for being one of the cheapest hosting providers in the market, they're still you're still going to end up paying more with Bluehost than with TenWeb. So that would be it pricing wise, and the information about the speed. Now, before shooting this video, I have created a table with all the results that I've been mentioning throughout the video, just for you to have a more visualized understanding about the whole the results of this case study that we've conducted. So let me go to that table, which is here. So basically, these are all the results, and if you take a look at it, you see that mobile page speed score and the desktop page speed score and the speed index, everything have just amazing results with TenWeb. The next good one would be Bluehost mobile page speed score wise, but their speed index is extremely slow. So if you're looking for a fast WordPress hosting provider, I would really not consider Bluehost since this is a really bad indicator. And then if we take a look at the desktop page speed scores, GoDaddy and HostGator are basically the same. Bluehost is a bit lower. And then the speed index of GoDaddy and HostGator are over 3 seconds. As I mentioned, you want to have a speed index of anything as close to zero as possible. So all these, all three of these hosting providers are basically very, very slow. So I don't know, if you are looking for a WordPress hosting provider that would be both, affordable and would have amazing, speed score results, then, I would really go with TenWeb, because, you're going to end up paying $120 in case of one website, and it would be $6 per website per year, in case you have 10 or more websites, to host. So, and you are going to have, these types of results, So basically, that would be it. I think the educated choice would be yours from now on.
So website speed matters, and it matters a lot. It affects the experience that users have with your website. It affects the ranking that your website will have on search engine result pages, and it also affects the conversions. So whenever choosing a WordPress hosting provider for your website, you really need to take into consideration how fast it will be. If you like this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave comments down below about how fast your WordPress website is.